Sweet Lord, I miss. Good evening. The doors of St. Alfred's Parish are open wide to welcome each and everyone, with a special acknowledgement to all who are visiting our parish community. During this prayerful time together, may we encounter Jesus and experience the joy of his presence. Now that we are open to full capacity, we would like to welcome home to Mass all those parishioners who have attended Mass by live stream. St. Alfred Church is a safe environment to worship God and to encounter the risen Christ in the breaking of the bread. It is here in person that we recognize the Lord and receive hope and healing. We need volunteers to count the Sunday collection after the 11:30 a.m. Mass. If you would like to volunteer to be a counter, please call the parish office at the number on the front of the bulletin. Father Donald Azzotti will be celebrating his 50th ordination anniversary here at St. Alfred Church with a Mass tomorrow, June 26th at 2:30 p.m. Everyone is welcome to attend this Mass of Thanksgiving. Refreshments to follow in St. Mark Room. Confessions at 6:30 p.m. on Monday, June 27th are canceled. As of Wednesday, July 6th, the Mass on that morning, on Wednesday morning, will be celebrated at 8 a.m. instead of 9 a.m. This is only for the months of July and August. The time of the Wednesday morning Mass will return to 9 a.m. in September. Volunteers are needed for adoration. Adoration is Monday to Friday from 9 to 4 p.m. If you would like to volunteer for 1 hour a week or more, please call the parish office. Those already signed up, we ask that you please show up for your allotted time. If you cannot, for whatever reason, come. If you cannot, for whatever reason, come. Please find a replacement. In the event that no one comes to relieve you at the end of your holy hour, kindly close the doors of the cabinet. If the doors of the cabinet are closed when you arrive for your holy hour, please feel free to open them. St. Alfred's Church will be having a parish barbecue Sunday, August 14th, after the 11:30 a.m. Mass. Save the date. Everyone is welcome. Volunteers are needed to help with the children's liturgy on Sundays starting in September. If you would like to volunteer for this ministry, please call the parish office. The synod report from the diocese is completed and available on our website. In the fall, we will be running the Alpha program every Wednesday evening for 11 weeks. Please see the bulletin for more information. Adoration will be canceled Friday, July 1st, due to Canada Day. The parish office will be closed on Friday, July 1st for Canada Day. Mass will be celebrated at 9 a.m. Today is the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Jesus had a single focus, fulfilling what he was called to be and do. And so he headed for Jerusalem, and what he knew was inevitable there. He warned the disciples and us not to be distracted in our calling by life's ordinary demands or the possibility of discomfort, pain, or death. It is hard to be single-minded with so many competing priorities in life. How do we balance our baptismal calling with the other demands we encounter? Where is our focus? Our celebrant this evening is Father Hugh.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Father.
My sisters and brothers in Christ, coming together as God's family, with confidence, let us ask his forgiveness, for he is full of mercy and compassion.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You're seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord spoke to the prophet Elijah and said, "You shall anoint Elisha, son of Shaphat, as prophet in your place." So Elijah set out from there and found Elisha, who was plowing. There were 12 yoke of oxen ahead of him, and he was with the 12th. Elijah passed by Elisha and threw his mantle over him. Elisha left the oxen, ran after Elijah and said, "Let me kiss my father and my mother, and then I will follow you." Then Elijah said to him, "Go back again, for what have I done to you?" Elisha returned from following Elijah, took the yoke of oxen and slaughtered them. Using the equipment from the oxen, he boiled their flesh and gave it to the people, and they ate. Then Elisha set out and followed Elijah and became his servant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, for freedom Christ has set us free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery. For you were called to freedom, brothers and sisters, only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for self-indulgence, but through love become slaves to one another. For the whole law is summed up in a single commandment: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. If, however, you bite and devour one another, take care that you are not consumed by one another. Live by the Spirit, I say, and do not gratify the desires of the flesh. For what the flesh desires is opposed to the Spirit, and what the Spirit desires is opposed to the flesh. For these are opposed to each other, to prevent you from doing what you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not subject to the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the days drew near for him to be taken up, Jesus set his face to go to Jerusalem. And he sent messengers ahead of him. On their way, they entered a village of the Samaritans to make ready for Jesus. But the Samaritans did not receive him, because his face was set toward Jerusalem. But when his disciples, James and John, saw it, they said, "Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them?" But Jesus turned and rebuked them. Then they went on to another village. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes, birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." To another, Jesus said, "Follow me." But he replied, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." But Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead. But as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but let me first say farewell to those at my home." Jesus said to him, "No one who puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, everyone, and good evening to those who are watching online. Today we are marking the 13th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Easter has come and gone. We've celebrated Pentecost, Trinity Sunday, Corpus Christi, and now we're going to try and sort out what did it all mean. It's a time to study discipleship. Luke understands this. From the moment Jesus turns his face and walks to Jerusalem, and for the next 9 chapters of the gospel, he takes us on a journey. We know that that journey ends in his arrest, in his suffering, nailed to the cross, dying, and of course, rising again. And on that journey, Luke asks us this: what does it mean to be a disciple of Jesus. So for the next few weeks, we will be walking with them as they misunderstand, misinterpret what it means to be a disciple of Christ. Today's gospel is the most important of all the journey stories, and it begins with Jesus resolutely saying to his disciples, and with great deliberation, "You follow me." Now, there's four lessons in this gospel, but I'm only going to look at two of them. They walk a little bit of the way, and they find themselves in Samaria. Now, the Samaritans are the children of Abraham. Many centuries ago, there was misunderstanding piled on misunderstanding. So the Jewish people, when they came back from the Babylonian exile and resettled in Israel, they didn't accept the Samaritans as being faithful. For payback then, Jews were not welcome in Samaria, so they had to walk all the way around it. When the disciples came back with a message of rejection, they wanted to call down fire to destroy them all. But Jesus rebukes them, scolds them. He said, "We'll go to another town." And of course, what he was telling them was, this is a new way of living we're starting here. Not the old way, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. It is a way of love, and it is demanding. We must not think that under any circumstances we can wish evil upon any human being. Just a few chapters before this, Jesus has said, if you're going to follow me, you must love your enemies. You must do good to those who hate you, and you must care for them. We take this teaching for granted, but do we practice it? Think of the war in Ukraine today. How can they love? Think of the rise of violence here in our own country. How can we love? But what Jesus is saying is this: a disciple must learn how to love. If he, she does not learn how to love, they might be walking with me, but their heart is not with me. So the first lesson to his disciples is this: when you go out to preach the kingdom of God, by word or example, remember you must do it with love, or just leave it alone. If we cannot love, we cannot know who God is. Then Jesus goes on a little bit further, and an eager young man comes up to him and says, "Teacher, where you go, I will go with you." And Jesus kind of smiles at him and says, "The foxes have their dens, birds of the air their nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." The second lesson is based on the fact that if we're going to be disciples of Jesus, we must be detached from everything but one thing, and that is Jesus himself. He doesn't mean we can't have homes to live in. He says we can only make one home your home, and that is in the heart of the Father. I'll share you a story that I came across in my reading for tonight. There was a very rich businessman who went to India, climbed up a high mountain to speak with a wise guru. When he entered the guru's house, he looked around and saw the guru was sitting on a carpet on the floor. The only other thing he had in the house was a little table in the corner. The businessman said to him, "Hey, where's your stuff?" The guru said, "What do you mean, stuff? I mean, you live here.
All you've got is a table and a little carpet. Where's your stuff? The guru says to him, where's your stuff? And he said, well, I'm just passing through. And the guru says to him, I'm just passing through. We are all pilgrims in this world, and our home is with God Himself. We're just pilgrims passing through. The world may seem to be a mess politically, economically, and morally, but disciples are asked to see the world with the eyes of Jesus and love the world with His heart. Jesus is calling us. Come with me, and I will show you that no matter who you are or what your state of life is worth living. Life can be full of hope. Life can be full of love. As we continue this journey in the Gospel of Luke for the next few weeks, remember this. He's not talking to his disciples of many years ago. He's talking to us because we are the disciples.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. My friends, as we struggle to be faithful to our own calling, let us pray for ourselves and for the many needs of people throughout our world.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that we may stay faithful to the challenging call of discipleship, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who work for and promote peace and true security across the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve the victims of war, for international medical emergency relief and human rights organizations, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the ability to resist the many cultural distractions that call us to physical comfort, financial success, and status, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students who are graduating, may the way of the Lord guide them as they make decisions which will affect their lives and their futures, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the environment, especially for those places in the world suffering from drought or flooding, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Donald Lazzotti, as we celebrate the 50th anniversary of his ordination to the priesthood, that Jesus, the High Priest, will continue to renew, increase, and strengthen in him the graces received at ordination, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Canada, we give thanks for the majestic beauty of its mountains, lakes, oceans, fields, and hills. Help us to be thankful for our freedom and to share resources with others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who suffered because of residential schools. Remember all those buried in unmarked graves. May the Lord grant them eternal rest and peace. May He also grant comfort and peace to all Indigenous people of Canada who mourn their loss. May we as a church continue to work towards healing and reconciliation. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick in our families and in our parish community, especially Marion Kelly, Winnie Coe, Richard D'Souza, Hyacinth Condino, Jane Coco, Doreen McKenna, Peter Ricciardi, Mel Cervantes, Felix Josipovich, Michaela Gabehart, Anna Chirozzi, Petra Cristofi, and Elaine Ryan. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Carmela Colinari Ferriaccio and Mary Lumac, for their family and friends who grieve them with love, at this Mass you remember Salvatore Pilato and Frank Evangelista. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, let us not forget that you are with us as we struggle on our journey with Jesus. Help us to focus on what is most important and dispel our confusion, doubts, and fears. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for praise and glory of his name, our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, Grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin Mary. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Gerard our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Alfred, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit. With a slight bow, let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those attending Mass online, the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. God bless you. The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
The body of Christ. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace now, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
For you are my God, you alone are my joy, defend me, O Lord. You give marvelous comrades to me, the faithful who dwell in your land, those who choose aliens. Securely my body shall rest.